Hey everyone, welcome to another tutorial with the TomTom Maps APIs. Today we're going to be doing some custom markers and pop-ups and how to add them into your website. Let's take a look. Okay, here we are again with the code from our last video. How to add a map to your website in 2 minutes. First, let's see if it still works. It looks fine. Now, if you don't know this, it is not mandatory to have a marker to display a pop-up. The SDK allows us to have them independently. Let me show you how. I am commenting out this section here where we create the marker, and I am adding a new pop-up object. And the pop-up, of course, also has a long and lat pair. And we can choose the text that will be displayed. And finally, we will add it to the map. Let's see what it does. Let's reload the page. And now you can see that instead of the marker, we have a single pop-up. It is interesting that the pop-up will disappear when you click. And since we don't have a reference to it, well, we lost it forever. In addition, the pop-up by default has a close button marked here as an X that it will also close the pop-up and it will be gone. Now, let's see how to remove that closing button from the pop-up. It's just passing the option close button to false, that property. And if we go back to the map and reload, we see that there is no close button anymore.
But the most common use case is to have a marker that when you click on it, the pop-up will appear on top.
To do that, we have first to get a reference to the pop-up. Let's call it pop-up. We are not going to need this set long and lat, and we don't need to add it to the map since it's going to get attached to the marker. Now we get a marker reference. We can set the pop-up to our pop-up reference. And going back to the map, reloading, and we see again the standard marker. And when we click on it, now we see the pop-up. Now, the pop-up is covering the marker. We solve that by placing an offset to the pop-up. For example, let's assume we know that the marker size is 50 pixels. So when we create the pop-up, we pass an offset half of the marker size. We have to anchor it to the bottom of the marker as well. Let's see it on the map. Now the marker is a bit more visible in the back. Still not totally. What I'm going to do is to make sure that the marker size is previously set.
But before that, let me tell you about the set text function. This is the least recommended way to actually add a text in a pop-up, simply because this text is going to be inserted in the DOM and can open a backdoor for injection attacks. So make sure that this text is sanitized before actually entering.
How do we do it better? When we can create a DOM element and assign it to the pop-up. Let's go create a div element. Document create element div. The inner HTML, we can put a hello there. And then we add the DOM element to the pop-up. Let's see it on the map. And I see that the pop-up is there. It's a bit different since we now added a P tag, remember? Okay, now we want to see how to change the marker itself. Remember, we created this size variable that never used it. Let's make the marker this size. And in the map now, we see that the marker is bigger. The pop-up is still at half the size, so let's adjust the offset to the current value. And now we see that the pop-up is right on top of the marker. So going back to the marker definition, we remove the size and we are going to add an element property. I think I can add a border element as the content. Let's do that first here. Of course, it doesn't exist. We have to create it. So let's create this as a div element. And let's add the class name as marker border. And again, of course, this doesn't exist yet, so we have to go to the style section and add it there. We have no style section. Let's create one. Okay, marker border. First, let's set the background and let's choose a color. The marker by default is a square box. We add a radius of 50% to make it round, and the width and height should be 50 pixels. Okay, let's see how it looks in the map. And we see now a color circle as the marker. We click on it and we see the pop-up. Nice. So how about adding now an image inside? I went to pexel.com to get a free to use image, and I want to give credit to Igor Starkov from Pexels. Thank you very much for this nice store image. I saved it as a JPEG in my current folder. Now I'm going to create a new style for a new class. Let's say it's the icon. We'll call it marker icon. Background should be on the center, so background position. The background size should be a bit smaller from the border. So we know that it's 50 pixels. Ready to wrap it, let's say it's 45 pixels. Again, border radius of 50% to make it round. And let's add width and height. Once we get this style, we have to assign it to a new element for this image. So we are going to create an icon element. Let's make it another div. The class name should be the new style, marker icon. And the background image is the downloaded image, the store. So the URL is here, it's a local file. And finally, we append the icon. And let's go back to the map. And you can see that it's now inside. Oh, it's not centered. We have to add some offsets. Back in the style section, the marker icon, we should add a left property that is half of the difference of the two sides. So the difference is 5 pixels, so it would be 2.5, and a top property with the same value. Oh, and let's not forget to set the position property to absolute. Let's see it. And there it is. So this was a very easy sample for you to change the marker in your maps.
And that was a very simple example. Let us know in the comments if you want more complex use cases. And as always, visit us in the developer portal for more tutorials. Again, thank you for watching and happy mapping.